Today's session, company accounts. We have to cover Unit 1, introduction to company accounts. Unit 2, we have to cover issue and forfeiture and reissue of the shares. Redemption of preference shares. And last one is issue of the ventures. So total 4 units in this chapter, company accounts. Normally students find it very difficult. Now remember, this is only the balance sheet. Company accounts will never reflected in your profit and loss account, any entry. All entries are through balance sheet, remember. And in balance sheet also, this is only related to capital accounts. So this is related to capital account. So first we will see basic concepts, introduction of company accounts. So first, why company? First concept, why there is a need of company? Company is expansion of the business activity. Normally it is to expand your business. Otherwise sole proprietor is also option for you, or private company, or sorry, not private company, its partnership firm is also option. But if your activities are expanding, in that case you will form a company. When you need a large amount of money, means you want to invest investment of shareholders, if you want extra money, huge money, projects are big, in that case sole proprietorship is of no use. And that's why we normally need company. Need of separate management from ownership. Separate management from ownership. So if company, in case management is different and ownership is different. To carry wealth creation activities through optimum utilization of resources. So in economics you know what is optimum utilization of resources, and that is possible in case of company. Company or corporations, that's why come into existence. So there, why there is need, you understood it, for expansion, for large amount, for management need is separation from the ownership, and to carry wealth maximization. Now let's try to understand meaning of company. The company, a word, it is the Latin word. Come means together, and pani is to breed, and that is the reason companies. Company means association of persons or merchant men discussing matters and taking food together. In history it is only they are coming together and having some dinner or lunch. As per law, this is formed and incorporated under Companies Act. So company means which is formed and incorporated under Companies Act 2013 or any of the previous companies laws. Are the individual holding shares of a company who are authorized by law to elect board of directors, shareholders. So shareholders, they elect board of directors, and board of directors will see the company, they run the company on behalf of shareholders. So who elect board of directors? Shareholders. Very good. Salient features. salient features, there are total 11 salient features. We will discuss it one by one. It is incorporated association, separate legal entity, perpetual existence, common seal, limited liability, separation of ownership from management, not a citizen, transferability of shares, maintenance of books, periodic audit, and right of access to information. So, one by one, incorporated association. So, incorporated association, it means a company cannot come into existence without incorporation, means somewhere you have to register it. So, company has to be registered with ROC. Separate legal entity means it is not affected by changes in the membership. Membership ke wajah se koi problem nahi hai. A company can contract, sue and be sued in its incorporated name and capacity. So, it is not affected by change in the membership. Perpetual existence. Company will continue for n number of years. Unke members ka death hoga, board of directors ke logon ka death hoga, par company ka kabhi bhi death nahi hoga. Company continues to be in existence despite the death, insolvency or change of the member. Next, common seal. Company can because company is not a natural person, and that's why company can't sign documents, and therefore you need common seal for the company and authorized signatory. So common seal, company cannot sign its documents. Limited liability. Liability is limited to the amount a shareholder has agreed on the shares allotted to him. No liability if shares are fully paid. So limited liability is limited to the amount a shareholder has agreed on the shares allotted to him. No liability if shares are fully paid. So that is the limited liability. Face value will be decided, and that face value, beyond that, ये shares की liability नहीं रहेगी. Separation of ownership from management. So I already explained you. Large number of shareholders, operational management becomes difficult. All shareholders come together in the company and they sit together or वो पूरे decisions ले रहे तो it's not possible. So they elect board of directors. Not a citizen. Although having legal existence, no citizenship rights and duties. So company does not have any citizenship rights, means they can't vote. Next, transferability of shares. Company is contributed by subscription of shares and are transferable except private limited companies. Means you can transfer your share to another person. There is no restriction. But wait, if the company is private company, then in that case it is transferability per restriction. Maintenance of books. Company has to maintain books, otherwise it attracts penalties. So compulsory books of accounts and gets it audited by the chartered accountant. This is mandatory provision, periodic audit on recommendation of board of directors. Shareholder will appoint chartered accountant and he will check all books of accounts. Right to access information. Shareholders can inspect his books of accounts. Also seek information from the directors by participating in meetings and through periodic reports. So right to access to information is also important. Shareholders should inspect books of accounts and he has right to inspect the books of accounts. I hope you are clear with the all concept of salient features of the company. So salient features, there are total 11 salient features. So one by one, chalo ek baar yaad kar lete hai. First one is incorporated association. Second one is separate legal entity. Third one is perpetual existence. Fourth one, common seal. Fifth one, limited liability. Sixth one, separation of ownership from not a citizen. Transferability of shares. Maintenance of books. Periodical audit and right to access to information. Now we will try to understand all types of companies. Types of companies are basically divided in 12 parts. Government company, foreign company, private company, public company, one person company, small company, listed company, unlisted company, unlimited company, company limited by shares, company limited by guarantee, and last one is subsidiary company. So first, what is government company? Government company means a company in which not less than 51% of the paid up capital held by state government, central government, or partly by central government and partly by state government, or includes a company which is a subsidiary company. So more than 50% share capital, not less than 51 means more than 50% is held by government. And government, as you know, central government is different and state government is different, or both. Foreign company means has a place of business in India and conduct business outside India. Has a place, a company or body corporate incorporated outside India, place of business in India and conducts any business activities in India. So foreign company, where it is incorporated? In the outside India. Private company. Private company means having paid up capital maximum rupees 1 lakh. Or higher paid up capital as prescribed by its article. Restricts right to transfer its shares. I already explained you. And they may ask you maximum number of members 200. Remember this MCQ, this is important. 200. Maximum number of members are 200 and minimum capital rupees 1 lakh. Minimum capital of 1 lakh. And maximum members 200. Minimum member 2 and maximum members 200. Public company. A company which not a private company and need minimum capital rupees 5 lakh. Remember, here it is 1 lakh and here it is. Next concept is new in Companies Act 2013, one person company. Previously a company has only one person, previously there is no concept of one person company, but now one person can form the company, but you have some rules and regulations to form one person company. Normally minimum two members are required, but now one person can form a company. Small company is also a new concept in which minimum capital, normally minimum capital of private limited is
1 lakh.
But here exceeding limit is given, exceeding. And that exceeding limit should not go beyond 50 lakhs. So paid up share capital not exceeding 50 lakhs is a small company. But higher amount can be prescribed, but this higher amount may be, yes, not more than 5 crores. So yes, higher amount may be prescribed, but this is not more than
5 crores.
And turnover limit is also given. Small company turnover is less than 2 crores. And higher limit can be prescribed, but not more than 20 crores. Not more than 20 crores. So this is the new concept which is added in 2013. Small company, paid up capital not exceeding 50 lakhs and the higher limit
5
crores. Turnover 2 crores and higher limit
20 crores.
Very good. Next concept is listed company. As you know, companies are listed on the stock exchange. Kabhi suna hoga, shares listed. For example, every company has to register, jo big company hai, like Reliance, Tata, Ambuja Cement, SCC, ab jo bhi naam aapko pata hai, Dr. Reddy, to ye sab companies are listed on the stock exchange. Even banks are also listed on the stock exchange. And every company which is listed on the stock exchange, kabhi naam suna hoga, Bombay Stock Exchange and National Stock Exchange. So we will go it in detail in IPs intermediate and final. But itna hi yaad rakho ki listed company is securities which are listed on the stock exchange. And sometimes, it means it is freely available, market mein available hota hai. Stock exchange listed mein kya fayda hota hai? Ki shares are freely available. You can buy it from Kanyakumari to Jammu Kashmir. Any person can buy it on the terminal. To ye jisme hota hai, ki stock exchange terminal se directly you can buy, to usko listed bola jata hai. And if it is not available in the market, it is known as unlisted company ka share. So having the securities which are not listed on the stock exchange is known as unlisted company. So remember this concept. बहुत ज़्यादा डिटेल में नहीं जा रहे, इंटरमीडिएट में यू हैव दिस इन योर लॉ, बट हम लोग अभी सिर्फ बेसिक समझ के ले रहे हैं. नॉर्मली यू शुड नो अकाउंटिंग फर्स्ट, बट दिस इज द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट की व्हाट इज कंपनी, दैट्स व्हाई आई एम टेकिंग दिस कॉन्सेप्ट. सो अनलिमिटेड कंपनी नॉट हैविंग एनी लिमिट ऑन लाइबिलिटी ऑफ इट्स मेंबर. सो एनी लिमिट ऑन लाइबिलिटी ऑफ इट्स मेंबर्स इज नोन एज अनलिमिटेड कंपनी. कंपनी लिमिटेड बाय शेयर्स. Company limited by shares means having liability limited to unpaid shares, only unpaid shares. 10 rupees ka share hai, 6 rupees are paid up, 4 rupees unpaid, so maximum 4 rupees is your liability. And company limited by guarantee. Members undertake to contribute to the assets of company in the events of being wound up. So ye bhi yaad rakhna, company limited by guarantee. Subsidiary company means a company in which holding company controls and controls the composition of board of directors and exercise or controls more than one half of the total share capital, either own or together with one or more its subsidiary companies. So subsidiary companies means holding company means with the company having control. Means suppose a company has shares in B company more than 51%. Means B company, who controls it? A. So A company is the holding company and B company is the subsidiary company. I hope you understood the basics. So holding and subsidiary company. Maintenance of books of accounts. Every company shall keep books of accounts in its registered head office. Every company shall prepare and keep its registered office books of accounts and other relevant books and prepares and financial statements for every financial year, which gives true and fair view of state of affairs of the company, including that of its branch office or offices. So financial statements you have to present compulsorily. Provide further, company may keep such books in electronic format. So company can keep its books of accounts in electronic format. Now let's try to understand preparation of financial statements. Financial statements means balance sheet, P&L, cash flow statement, statement of changes in equity, and explanatory notes. So financial statements. Financial statements comply with notified accounting standards. Board of directors shall lay financial statements at every annual general meeting. Financial statement includes balance sheet, which is under schedule 3 of the part 1. Then profit and loss account, this is cash flow statement, statement of changes in equity, and in last explanatory notes. So balance sheet, P&L, cash flow statement, statement of changes in equity, and explanatory note. So each and every financial statement is important. Above provisions are applicable to all except, means this financial statement format is also fixed, but this is not applicable to insurance company because they have its own act. If you have your own act, then schedule 3 is not applicable to you. Own act will give you the balance sheet ka presentation. You have it in the intermediate. Banking company, they have it their own act. Any company engaged in generation or supply of electricity and any other class of company for which statements are prescribed act under the act governing such class of company. So ye aapka pura format. Now you have to understand part 1, it is the form of balance sheet. Balance sheet mein first you have to write what is the name of the company, balance sheet, serial number, particulars, note number, and there are two comparatives, means current year figures are compared with the last year. So equity and liabilities is the first head. Equity and liabilities mein shareholders fund, share capital, just remember this format, reserves and surplus, money received against share warrants, share application money pending allotment, non-current liabilities mein long-term borrowings, deferred tax liability, other long-term liability, long-term provisions, current liability, short-term borrowings, trade payable, other current liability and short-term provisions, assets mein non-current assets, fixed asset, tangible assets, intangible assets, capital WIP, intangible assets under development, non-current investment, deferred tax asset you will understand at CA final year intermediate level, long-term loans and advances, other non-current assets, current assets mein CIT CSO, C for current investment, I for inventory, T for trade receivable, cash and cash equivalent, short-term loans and advances, other current assets, and total. So this is the pro forma of the balance sheet. At least you should remember the names of each and every head, and detailed explanation you will understand. You have a separate topic, financial statement at intermediate level. So this is the form of balance sheet which is covered in part 1 of schedule 3. That is their favorite question, ki where it is covered. It is covered in the schedule 3 part 1, and part 2 is the P&L account. Part 2 is P&L. Tisra cash flow statement hota hai, notes to accounts, and last mein aapka SOC statement of changes in equity and notes to accounts.